So we will be doing elbow joint today. So in order to study elbow joint, you should remember all the features what we have studied with the osteology of humerus, radius and ulna. Because these are the things which are actually participating in the formation of elbow joint. So when you check for the lower end of the humerus, so what are the presenting parts we have better? See, this is the medial end. Towards which we have medial epicondyle. This is lateral end, that is the lateral epicondyle. So at the lower end, the articulating things are, this is trochlea, which is like a pulley. And then we have capitulum. Okay. Then above the trochlea, this area is the, what fossa is this? Sternoid.
Olecranon.
Olecranon is behind, bete, piche.
Coronoid.
We are seeing in front now. This is anterior.
Okay.
Okay.
Coronoid.
This is coronoid fossa. What is the name of this fossa, beta? Above the capitulum, radius ke upar hai. So,
radial fossa.
Yeah, very good. So, we have coronoid fossa and the radial fossa. Now, correspondingly, if you observe here, so we have ulna bone. Okay. And this is the coronoid process. In fact, in front we have. Okay. Then this is the head of the radius. Next is the radius, radial tuberosity. So when we are doing extreme extension, then you will see the coronoid fossa and radial fossa are not occupied by the radius and ulna. But suppose when we are doing flexion, then you will see the coronoid process of ulna will come and occupy the coronoid fossa. The head of the radius will come and occupy the radial fossa. Okay, so that is the purpose of these fossae, which will facilitate extreme flexion of the elbow joint. So this is anterior view. Once we see from behind, then it will be posterior view. So in the posterior view, as Imad was confused, from behind we have one fossa, that is the olecranon fossa. Now when you check with ulna bone, we have this, the superior projection of the ulna, we know it is olecranon process. So when we are doing extension of the elbow, you will see the olecranon process of the ulna is coming and articulating or getting fixed in the olecranon fossa of the lower end of the humerus. Okay, so these are the points what you should thoroughly understand when we are talking about elbow joint. Okay. So above the trochlea, we have coronoid fossa. Above the capitulum, we have the radial fossa. Medial and lateral epicondyles are not participating in the formation of elbow joint. Okay, beta? So just remember, head of the radius, we have the ulnar notch also, we will see. Now from this picture, whatever we are able to see, let us try to appreciate. The lower end of the humerus, only capitulum, trochlea will participate. Okay, so medial and lateral epicondyles are not participating. Of course, they will give attachment to the ligaments. Okay, now what is the name of this notch in the ulna we have? Ulnar notch, isn't it? Or the trochlear notch. This is the head of the radius where you have the articular cartilage. What is the other name of articular cartilage? Hyaline cartilage, isn't it? Okay, that is. Now see here, only the capitulum, which is like a cap, you call it as capitulum, and then this is trochlea. Then we have the trochlear notch and the head of the radius superiorly, it has a fossa. So that those areas only are covered with hyaline cartilage. That means only these are the parts which are participating in the formation of the elbow joint. Okay. So this is the articular cartilage. So what type of joint it is? Elbow joint. It is like hinge of a door. You can just move only in one direction. Can you move your elbow downwards? No. Like a hinge of a door, it moves only in one direction. That's the reason it is called as hinge joint. Because three bones are involved, you call it as compound hinge joint. Okay. It's also called as cuboidal articulation because it is seen at the level of cuboidal fossa. So we have three bones involving. So it includes three joint cavities. What are those? This is between the humerus and ulna. You call it as humero-ulnar. This is between the humerus and radius. You call it as humero-radial. Okay. And you are finding the head of the radius is fixing in the radial notch of the ulna, forming the superior radio-ulna joint. So that's how it is compound. Okay, three joints are involved in the formation of this joint. Okay, now you can further see, like, this is the medial epicondyle, lateral epicondyle. Okay, trochlea, capitulum. Okay, this is the coronoid process, the trochlear notch, which is fixed in the trochlea of the humerus. Okay, head of the radius fixed in the capitulum, that you can see here, in fact. Okay, so to hold the head of the radius in position, we have a ligament, you call it as annular ligament. Okay, annular ligament. So now the bones forming the lower end of the humerus, upper end of the ulna and radius. Okay, so this articulation of the elbow joint. See, this is the trochlea and capitulum of the humerus above. Whatever I told you with the help of picture is texted here, nothing new. Already you got the concepts, I guess. Okay, so this is trochlea and capitulum of the humerus above, trochlear notch of the ulna below. This is the trochlear notch, exactly. You are finding, see, this is the olecranon process. This is the coronoid process. This is the trochlear notch. So the trochlear notch will be fixing in the trochlea of the humerus. Okay, then. So this is the head of the radius we have below. Okay, now. Different colors have been used. Can you label them now? What is B? A is lateral epicondyle or medial epicondyle? Hansraj? Hema? Imad? Abhinav?
Lateral, ma'am. Sorry, you mute.
Achha, theek hai beta. Ye lateral hai. Ye kya hai, B?
Yeah, ma'am.
What is this labeling showing us?
Capitulum.
Very good. C is?
Trochlea.
This one, D1 is?
Medial epicondyle.
Yeah, very good. Now, this is from behind, posterior view.
Olecranon fossa.
Yeah, olecranon fossa. Very good. So now you got the concept. It becomes very easy for you. Now, see here, because bony understanding is very, very important. What are the components of bone? This is the anterior view of ulna bone. You are finding this is the olecranon process, coronoid process. In between these two, I use the word hood, if you remember, isn't it, when we were doing ulna bone, isn't it? So this is a trochlear notch. This is the radial notch where the head of the radius comes and fix. The annular ligament is actually attached to the margins of the radial notch to hold the head of the radius in position. Okay, beta? And then, so yeah, side view, lateral view, again olecranon process, then coronoid process, trochlear notch. You can see the radial notch very clearly. This is intended for the head of the radius to articulate here to form which joint? Between the ye wala hinge hai pura. Between radius and ulna, upper ki taraf kaun sa joint hai? Like superiorly
radio ulnar.
Superior radio ulnar joint. You should be because between radius and ulna we have three joints. One is superior radial ulnar joint, the other is inferior radial ulnar joint. In between two, we have intermediate radial ulnar joint. That is nothing but interosseous membrane. Intermediate radial ulnar joint was once asked as 3 marks question. Elbow joint can come as either 5 marks or SA. Okay? So this is, again, something like a viva for you. A is representing what process? Olecranon process. Okay, this A is representing coronoid process. Then what is this notch?
Trochlear notch.
Trochlear notch. What is this notch?
Radial notch.
Radial notch for the head of the radius. Okay, now this is the superior view of radius and ulna. This is how the head of the radius looks. It has concavity covered with articular cartilage. Okay, so this is the superior aspect of ulna bone, which is showing the trochlear notch. Olecranon process above, coronoid process below. Okay, this is head of the radius, neck. What is this? Radial tuberosity, isn't it? Which muscle is taking its insertion here?
Biceps.
Very good, Hansraj. Biceps brachii. Very good. Posteriorly or anteriorly?
Camel.
आगे की तरफ है या पीछे की तरफ है इंसर्शन?
आगे की तरफ है मैम.
आगे की तरफ बरसा, isn't it? Biceps brachii. I told you it's a very important short note, 5 marks question. What is the action it does? Supination. Screwing type of movements. Everything is controlled by biceps. Very very important. Okay, beta. All these will be your viva questions in your theory, like practical viva. So this is the superior thing what you are doing. Okay, head of the radius, superior aspect. Now this is very much close up picture showing us head of the radius, capitulum, trochlear notch, trochlea, coronoid fossa, radial fossa, medial epicondyle, lateral epicondyle, side view, fixing of the trochlear notch into the trochlea, head of the radius into the capitulum. Okay, so now let us first, three components are there. Now let us discuss one by one. Humero-ulnar joint is a hinge joint. Bones forming the humeral ulnar are above, you are finding the trochlea, okay, and also the coronoid fossa, and olecranon fossa is behind, okay, this one. So below you will see this trochlear notch of ulnar, okay. The humeral ulnar joint is this. It's a synovial joint of hinge variety. It can perform two movements. One is flexion and the other is extension. During flexion, what did I say? The trochlear, what is this process, beta? Coronoid process comes in and fixes in the coronoid fossa. Head of the radius comes in, fixes in the radial fossa. Okay. During extension, the olecranon process and comes and fits in the olecranon fossa. Okay. You can see this is extended elbow only. Nicely, the olecranon process has fixed itself into the olecranon fossa of the lower end of the humerus. This view is from behind extension movement. Okay, that is. So humero-ulnar joint, the trochlea is resembling a pulley. Okay, you are finding a groove here between, you call it as the spiral groove, dividing into, this is the medial flange and this is the lateral flange. Medial flange is actually broad and it is projecting about 6 mm below. It is not in straight line, see, if you draw it from, it is little lower down, 6 mm. Below, this is very important because it is responsible for the formation of carrying angle. What is carrying angle? Is your elbow straight or is it making a little angle? It's thoda angle is there. Okay, that is nothing but carrying angle. How is it formed? Because you are finding the medial flange is 6 mm below when you compare with the lateral flange. Carrying angle itself can be a 3 marker. So humero-ulnar joint, we have the non-articular depressions, that is the coronoid fossa in front and olecranon fossa behind. Okay, coronoid fossa in front accommodates coronoid process of ulna. Already I have explained everything, this is textured part. Olecranon fossa is accommodating olecranon process of ulna in extension. Okay, nothing to worry, everything I have discussed. So trochlear notch of ulna is reciprocally saddle shaped and formed by the articular surface of this olecranon process and this coronoid process. That means superiorly the articular surface of olecranon process, inferiorly the articular surface of coronoid process. In between these two, you are finding there is a non-articular narrow strip. Okay? So we know it comes in contact with the during flexion of elbow joint. Okay? Now coming to humero-radial joint. This one was hinge joint, right? Humero-ulnar was hinge, isn't it? Whereas humero-radial is something like ball and socket, what we discussed yesterday, isn't it? Shoulder joint. So there you had head of the humerus and the glenoid cavity. This is reverse. Here you have the capitulum as head and the head of the radius superiorly, it shows a cavity. So that it allows the head of the, like this capitulum, to fix into the head of the radius. Okay, that's how it resembles ball and socket joint of synovial variety. Okay, synovial joint it is. Okay, it can be sometimes also called as gliding or plane joint. Okay, usually we do not find a true movement here. Okay, the movement is much more facilitated at humeral ulnar joint because of that hood-like trochlea, which is quite big to accommodate the trochlea pulley. Okay, so this also, like, again, it just texted what we have already studied. Humero-radial part, above you have capitulum and this is the radial fossa, isn't it? Below we have the head of the radius. Okay, the humero-radial joint is again ball and socket. Ball is capitulum, socket is head of the radius. During flexion you will see head of the radius comes and fixes in the radial fossa of humerus. This is the radial fossa. Okay, radial fossa, coronoid fossa. Okay, now let us see what are the various ligaments we have in the elbow joint. So, always I told you, outermost covering is always, what do we have, Hema? Capsular ligament. Okay, inside of the capsular ligament is lined by synovial membrane. Medially we have ulnar collateral ligament, laterally we have radial collateral ligament. Okay, so now let us see the capsular ligament. So by looking at this picture, you can actually see the attachments. No? So that means margins of the radial fossa, margins of the coronoid fossa anteriorly, then margins of the head of the radius and the margins of the trochlear notch. Okay, behind margins of the olecranon fossa. Okay, whatever you are finding over here is all capsule. Over the capsule, thickenings will be ligaments. Over the capsule. Okay. So capsular ligament. See proximal attachment. We will see distal attachment. We will see with radius ulna. Inside covering will be the synovial membrane. See the capsule is cut here. So as to see the interior. Inside you are finding the capitulum and trochlea. And we can see like it. The radial fossa and coronoid fossa are actually covered by the fibrous capsule. Okay, so inside the capsule, when you do, if you have done the dissection and if you remember something, lot of oily thing comes out inside the joints. That is nothing but the fat, nothing but the synovial fluid, which helps in lubrication of joints. Okay, that is. Now coming to the attachment of joint capsule of this elbow joint, superiorly it is attached to the humerus. Upper margins of the coronoid fossa and radial fossa, below to the margins of trochlear notch of the ulna and annular ligament of the head of the radius. Okay, beta. So this is anteriorly, behind I told you olecranon. See, whatever red animation you are finding, that is all anterior attachment. Posteriorly, what is this fossa we have? Olecranon fossa. So above, it is attached to the margins of olecranon fossa of the humerus. Below, it is attached to the upper margin and sides of the trochlear notch, okay, of the ulna and annular ligament. Okay, if you remember these pictures, if you review once, you will remember everything. Okay, so this is how it goes. Then synovial membrane, it will be inside lining, isn't it? The capsule is outside. This green lining inside, whatever greenish and bluish, whatever we have, is synovial membrane. What is the purpose of synovial membrane function? It produces synovial fluid. The joint cavity is filled with synovial fluid, which helps in the smooth movements of the joint, that is lubrication. Okay, the synovial membrane is lining the capsule and it is covering the fatty pads. Where do we have the fatty pads? The floor of coronoid fossa fat is there, radial fossa, olecranon fossa. All these pads of fat are covered with the synovial membrane. Okay. Then, so synovial membrane is continuous. Below, with the synovial membrane, what we have with the next joint, that is the superior radial ulnar joint. Okay. Now let us see the ligaments. Now see here, you are finding this is the medial side of the elbow joint. That means what is this projection, Hansraj? Medial side, lower end of the humerus.
Medial epicondyle.
Very good. Medial epicondyle. You are finding the shape of the ligament. Before texted part, I am giving you some brainstorming type of exercise, lid opener, so that you understand better. Mm-hmm. Okay. So, yeh kaisa hai beta shape? It looks like a triangle. So this is apex and this is base. So suppose if you consider it as anterior extension, it is extending from medial epicondyle to konsa area? Coronoid process, no? Coronoid process, है ना? ये coronoid है या olecranon है पीछे का? This is completely trochlear notch, isn't it? So the you are finding the anterior fibers are extending from the medial epicondyle to the coronoid process. Posterior fibers again from the medial epicondyle to the olecranon process. So you are finding in between also you are finding intermediate fibers bridging the anterior and posterior fibers. Okay, these are all intermediate fibers. Okay, now let us see what is written. As you said, ulnar collateral ligament looks like a triangle. It's a triangular expansion. It has anterior band, it has posterior band, then it has intermediate or the inferior band. Okay, the anterior band, yellow in color, it is strong cord-like band between the medial epicondyle and the coronoid process. Posterior band is comparatively weaker between the medial epicondyle and olecranon process. Isn't it? It's labeled here. This is coronoid process. This is olecranon process. Inferior band is this between the anterior and posterior band. You are finding inferior band. And between these two bands, whatever fibers you are finding, those are intermediate fibers. They fill up the gap between the anterior and posterior band. Is that clear, beta?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Then next, see, this is complete picture. Now, medial or ulnar, same ligament it is. So what are the muscles which we have already studied? Do you remember the insertion of triceps? Superior surface of the olecranon process. Upper ka olecranon hai na, superior surface. That's how you will see the medial ulnar collateral ligament is now overlapped by the triceps. You remember common flexor origin is medial epicondyle?
Yeah.
Yes. So flexor carpi ulnaris is there, flexor digitorum superficialis. We have recently studied ulnar nerve. I told you humerus is funny bone because ulnar nerve course goes behind the medial epicondyle. So that when you rest on the table or chair, when it is just slipping, you will get the tingling sensation. Okay, so all these are closely related to the ulnar collateral, also called as medial collateral ligament. Okay, then on the lateral aspect, we have this ligament that is radial collateral ligament, which is again a triangular expansion. So, Ritika, can you tell me from where till where it is extending, beta? What is the name of this projection of humerus? It's labeled anyhow. Okay.
Lateral epicondyle.
From here it is moving to which point, beta? Which bone it is going to? Which is the lateral bone? Lateral bone, beta. Lateral bone.
Okay, radius.
Radius. So upper end of the radius is round, no? What do you call it as? Head of the radius.
Capital.
Head of the radius.
Head of the radius. What is that round ligament surrounding the head of the radius called as, Ritika? Is like a ring. Whenever it is like a ring, what is the word used in anatomy?
Annular ligament.
Very good. Annular ligament. So again, it has anterior fibers, then posterior fibers. Of course, the inferior band here you can see as the annular ligament. Now let us see. Annular ligament here you are finding. Okay, anteriorly in the ulnar bone, you will see the supinator crest. Just below the coronoid process, we will see the supinator crest. Now let us see, this lateral or radial collateral ligament is triangular expansion. Apex is attached to lateral epicondyle. Base is attached to the upper margins of the annular ligament, this round ring-like blue color. Okay, so relations are here, you will find a muscle that is supinator and extensor carpi radialis brevis. I hope you remember lateral epicondyle is a seat for common extensor origin. Okay, common extensor origin. This is our annular ligament. Okay. Now, I told you olecranon process is receiving the insertion of which muscle?
Triceps.
Very good.
Triceps.
Triceps. Very good. Okay, below which you are also finding bursa. Why do we have bursa?
Frictionless.
Then to prevent friction.
What is the action of triceps? Extension of the elbow, right? So much of friction will be there. So to avoid that, we have bursa. Very good. So just below the olecranon process, you call it as subcutaneous olecranon bursa. Okay. Then just below this tendon also we will see, that is the subtendinous olecranon bursa. Okay. Biceps, you told me it is getting inserted in radial tuberosity. No, there also I just mentioned like we have a bursa there. Okay. Now, if you remember cuboidal fossa, you will automatically write everything in for the relations of elbow joint. Ritika, do you remember, beta? MBBR or MBBS?
MBBR, yes, ma'am.
Ah, beta. Medial most is?
Medial nerve.
Very
medial
good.
Medial nerve.
Excellent. What is the name of this artery? B.
Brachial artery.
Excellent. What is the name of this tendon which is cut? MBB. One more B.
Bicipital aponeurosis.
That was in the roof and this is biceps tendon in fact. Okay, beta?
Biceps tendon. Okay.
Then what is the name of this nerve you are finding? MBBR. Last one. Or MBBS.
Superficial branch of radial nerve.
Excellent. Superficial branch of radial nerve. Do you remember under which muscle it is running? Yatika?
Brachioradialis.
Excellent. Brachioradialis. So you know everything now. Can you name this muscle? Name it?
Superficialis.
Correct. Superficialis. Very good. I'm very happy. Everybody is answering. So as Ritika told just now, MBBS, median nerve, brachial artery, biceps tendon, and superior branch of radial nerve. Or superficial, sorry. Then you are also finding, if you lift this biceps tendon, underlying that, you will see brachialis muscle. Behind, what is the name of the muscle which we have behind, Ritika? Specific answer.
Triceps.
Excellent. So, piche, you have triceps. Triceps brachii with bursa. Okay. And also, what is the name of this muscle we have? Anconius.
Okay. Anconius.
Yeah, very good. So, medially, medial epicondyle is a seat of common flexors, right? Laterally, we know. It gives origin to common extensor, origin of forearm. Okay, so simple it is. We have already discussed anastomosis around elbow joint. As a separate lecture, I have clearly explained you. So the blood supply of the elbow joint comes from the anastomosis around elbow joint, which is formed by the brachial artery, radial artery, ulnar artery, recurrent branches. Isn't it? Go through once. Okay, that is cuboidal anastomosis. So, what is the nerve supply? You are finding three nerves related to this joint, right? Behind the medial epicondyle, you are finding ulnar nerve. In front, you are finding median nerve. Okay, and as you go laterally, you are also finding radial nerve. Okay, so musculocutaneous nerve is also ending here. It becomes cutaneous, isn't it? So, that is. Then, so what are the various movements and muscles bringing about movement? We should know. So flexion is how many degrees, beta? Whatever we do like this, that is 150 degrees. Okay, extension is something like this. It makes joint close packed. So flexion. So these are the muscles what we have seen, like brachialis, biceps brachii. We saw in the front of the arm. Okay, brachioradialis we have seen in the extensor compartment. Extension, we see triceps and anconius. Okay, that is. I hope you will be able to tell everything now. Okay, so that is movements. Then carrying angle, I told you it is very, very important because it itself can come as a 3 marks question. I told you medial flange, whatever you see in the trochlea, is 6 mm low, because of which you are finding. There is some angle formed which is called as, this angle is the carrying angle. Okay, when the elbow is fully extended and the forearm supinated, the arm and forearm, they form an obtuse angle which is open on lateral side. Okay, so it is about 170 degrees in male and 167 degrees in female, average is 163. So whenever we are flexing the elbow joint, you will see it disappears. Okay. So why is it this formed? What is the purpose of this carrying angle? So suppose you are carrying a heavy object like bucket full of water, you will see the bucket is kept away from our body, isn't it? So that type of movements are facilitated because of the presence of carrying angle. Okay, so it permits the forearm to clear the hips in swinging movements during walking, and it is important when carrying objects. Okay, yes. These two functions it does. So when you measure it on medial side, it is 15 meter. Don't get confused. In some books it is given like this, in some books it is measured the other way. Both are correct. Okay, that is. So that slide you try to remember, that's enough. Coming to the applied anatomy. So normal elbow joint, it looks like this. I kept x-rays also, it will be complete. So this is the lower end of the humerus. You are finding olecranon fossa, olecranon process, head of the radius. I hope you can easily understand because we have discussed much. What is this coronoid process? This is olecranon process. This is trochlear notch. This is trochlea, isn't it? Trochlea. This is radial tuberosity, no? Neck of the radius, head of the radius. You should be able to pinpoint when the examiner is asking you, okay? So we have different types of fractures, but you can write to one or two, but I kept many pictures, okay? Above the condyles, you will see the fractures are supracondylar fractures, okay, like this, okay? So already I discussed about Volkmann's ischemic contracture, that is the blood vessel is damaged. You will see the extensors will not be able to work and the muscles will become contracted. See what are the various different types of fractures we have, you can see here. Okay. So here you are finding the medial epicondylis fracture. This is capitulum. That means this is lateral epicondyle. This is the lower end of the humerus. Okay. This is, if it is so many pieces, you basically call it as comminuted fracture. This is the fracture of trochlea, fracture of capitulum, Y-shaped fracture we have. Okay, intercondylar, different types of fractures we have. Okay, so fracture of capitulum, you can just look at the pictures. Okay, fracture of capitulum, X-ray is also here. Okay, this is olecranon process is fractured. Okay, so you are finding, see, ulnar nerve is behind the medial epicondyle. Okay, that also may be damaged. Okay, there may be sometimes fracture of the radial neck. Okay, so different types of fractures. Dislocation also may be possible sometimes. We have three bony points alignment, no? Radius, humerus, ulna, isn't it? So if it is disturbed, that is dislocation. Okay. You can check here with the picture. The olecranon process is slipped out from the olecranon fossa. That is dislocation.